Interstate improvements are in the works in our area. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local along I-85. Mike, work will likely happen where you are right now, right?
Yeah, that's right, Carol. This is Gossett Road along I-85 in Spartanburg County, and that yellow sign over my shoulder is where the highway goes from three lanes until two. Well, a widening project is on the list to fix the next 16 miles far into Cherokee County. For 5 years,
you hear a lot of blown tires.
Mike Phillip has had a front row seat for the scary show.
You mostly hear the horns.
I-85 puts on every day in Cherokee County.
It can be tied up for hours.
A fence and a frontage road separate his business, Progressive Embroidery and Printing, from the traffic. He drives this stretch.
It's so easy to have a wreck.
And his mailbox is just feet from the interstate.
You see a lot of them come through the little fence.
Cherokee County Coroner Dennis Fowler.
It's a very bad stretch of roadway.
Has worked 24 fatal accidents on I-85 since taking office in 2007.
It's even very dangerous for public safety workers to be out there. My office, our fire and personnel out there as well, EMS. Because if you close one lane, you're taking traffic down to another lane, a single lane.
He says distracted driving and speeding are problems, but so is the fact that the highway is only two lanes on each side. But there's now a plan to widen it.
I have encouraged this for a long time.
The project is on a long list that includes redoing the I-85, 385 interchange in Greenville County. There's $550 million on the table, a plan worked out between the General Assembly, the Department of Transportation, and a board that basically borrows money for road work. Your tax money foots the bill, and you'll likely be waiting years for the work to be done.
It should have been done years ago.
That list of approved projects still has to go up for final approval. That is set to happen early next month. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Spartanburg County.